In the last video, we looked at a few logical expressions for a simple garage or a porch light problem. So to quickly recap, we looked at a problem where we had a light sensor, a motion sensor, and a manual switch. And depending on what configurations we had a light bulb that turned on. So our computer's processing logic for this statement, which said, if it is dark outside and a motion sensor detects someone at the door, or the light switch is manually turned on, then turn on the lights. Our computer's processing logic was motion and not bright or switch. Now let's take a look at every single simple expression we looked at in our last example. The first very simple one was called turn on the lights if it was not bright outside. The second one we looked at said turn on the lights if there was movement and it was not bright outside. And the third expression we looked at said turn on the lights if there was motion and it was not bright or if we turn on the switch manually. So if you look at every expression that we looked at in the last video, we see that a number of keywords keep appearing that combine the inputs and produce a certain output. For example, in the first example, the keyword is not. The brightness sensor or the light sensor detects whether it's bright or not outside. And if it is not bright, turn on the lights. In our second example, we had a motion sensor and we had a light sensor. So our light bulb turned on only if there was motion and it was not bright. So we have a keyword and not. Similarly, in the final one, we added an additional keyword called or. These keywords help us make some kind of logical inference from the ex word expression that we have. And or not are basically keywords we could use to convey any logical description or a logical expression. These are called universal logic. We can basically communicate with another human being by using by basically combining different terms with ands, ors, and nots. And even if we didn't speak perfectly, or perfect English in this particular case, we would be able to communicate the message. So our processing, we basically understand each other by using these keywords and not ors, example. So our computers are also built using logical expressions. Our computers are built to process logical expressions. So we have certain things for ands, certain things for ors, and certain things for nots. So in the next couple of minutes, we're going to look at these three items and see how we might be able to build the processing system of a computer. The not gate, we call it the not logic. Not basically has two things. So if I have something called A as an input, A can be either true or a false. Not A, the output of not false means true, and not true means false. In computer logic, we draw this computer schematic for a not as this, and we call this the not gate or the inverter. It inverts whatever is on the input side and produces an output. So that triangle followed by a small circle or a bubble is called the not logic gate. Let's take this example of lights equals not bright. That basically corresponds to bright, when bright is false, so it's not bright. Bright is false, it's not bright, lights will turn on. When it's bright is true, lights will turn off. So this logical expression can be written in the form of a table. Since this table has true and false statements in it, this table is also called the truth table. Now, in terms of computing system, the input was bright and the output was lights. And this not gate, the triangle with a bubble, is the basic processing unit in this particular case. Now, let's go and look at the next one, an and keyword. The AND keyword basically takes two or more things and produces a true if and only if every input is true. For example, let's consider two inputs, A and B. If A is false and B is false, the output A and B is false. If A is false and B is true, the output is still false. The output is only true if A is true and B is true. We draw this as this. Two inputs and an output. It can have multiple outputs, more than two output. It can have more than two inputs. Now let's take an example of our logic. Light equals motion and not bright. In this case, let's enumerate every possible case. Bright is false, so not bright means true. And motion could be, let's say motion was false. In this case, should we turn on the lights? It is not bright outside, but there is no movement, so the light should not be turned on. In this case, second example, it's not bright outside, so not bright is true. Motion is true. So it's not bright outside, and there's some kind of motion detected, so the light should come on. True. Third line, brightness is true. That means it's bright outside. Not bright is false. That means it's not. It's still bright outside, and there's no movement. So it's bright outside and there's no movement, so there's no need for the light strip to be turned on. Finally, the fourth case, where we have bright is true, so it's daylight outside. There's also movement. Well, there's daylight outside, so there is no need to turn on the lights, so the light's expression stay false. So this expression can be drawn as a bright into a not gate, which produces not bright. The result of that is then put into an AND logic gate to produce a final lights. So this lights is equal to motion AND gate, so this is the AND, not bright.